table was introduced by a Russian scientist called Dmitry Mendel in the year 1869. He was the first to come up with the arrangement of a periodic table, and he arranged it according to the increasing atomic mass of all the elements. So all the elements you can ever think of, they are present in the periodic table. And this is the structure of the periodic table. Structure of the periodic table. The periodic table is divided into a group and a period. The periodic table has 8 groups and 7 periods. Group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sorry, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Group 8 is also called group 0. It is called group 8 because it has complete electrons in the outermost shell. And it's called group 0 because it has no bonding electron. It has 0 bonding electrons, so it doesn't bond with any other element in the periodic table. So in group 1, we have hydrogen. Hydrogen has 1 electron. So all the elements in group 1, they are univalent, means they have 1 electron at the outermost shell. Group 2, they are all divalent because they have 2 electrons in the outermost shell. So these are the periods. We have period 1, period 2, period 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Period 2 is divided into groups and period. Now, these are the groups. The horizontal are the groups, while the vertical are the periods. Now, the group 2 and group 3, we have the transition metals. They are all metals. In between group 2 and group 3, we have the transition metals. All the elements here, they are metals. They are all metals. Starting from calcium, which is 20. Now, all the elements here, the atomic number are arranged accordingly, which hydrogen is 1, helium is 2, lithium 3, beryllium 4, boron 5, carbon 6, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, neon, and sodium, magnesium. All this, they are arranged according to increasing atomic mass and also increasing atomic number. Alright, that's that for that. Please, pause.